very excited because in front of me, I have the brand new Shit Lokius 6-band balanced or unbalanced equalizer. So, just to warn you ahead of time, if you're somebody who shudders at the sound of equalizers because you like to drink your coffee black, so to speak, and don't like to add any flavoring to your sound, click away and click away fast. But if you're like me, somebody who's a little bit more indulgent, somebody who's a little bit more pragmatic, who likes to tailor things to your personal tastes, stick around, because I've got some fun information to share with you and some important information as well, depending on your setup. Okay? So this is the brand new Shit Lokius 6-band EQ, and like I said, balanced or unbalanced. And this is the bigger brother of the Shit Loki Mini Plus, the updated version of the Shit Loki, which is a four-band unbalanced equalizer, albeit excellent. I've had a chance to test out the Shit Loki Mini Plus and compare it to the Shit Lokius for quite some. I spent several days bouncing back and forth between these two, so I can offer you a very good comparison and let you know whether it's worth the upgrade or whether you should save a little bit of money, because there's a little bit of a price increase between these two different products. And I, in my particular use case, I compared this to my Monolith THX-788 that has a 6-band parametric EQ, and on using my test rig, which was the my Shit stack over here, which consists of the Bifrost 2 and the Jotunheim 2 as well. The headphones that I've used in this particular use case are the Heifemann Anandas, which I've reviewed right over here, and the Focal Clears. Planar magnetic, dynamic. This is significant depending on your use case and depending on your purchasing decision, okay? That's actually significant when it comes to things like EQ. So we're gonna start with the Loki Mini Plus. Despite the fact that it only comes in a single-ended connection, if you are somebody who only likes to connect entirely through balanced connections to get all of the power and the dynamic range out of it, well, your decision's made for you. Get the Lokius, because it's the only one that comes with fully balanced 3-pin XLR connections. However, despite that, I can attest to the fact that it is a completely transparent equalizer. It does not introduce any kind of distortion. It doesn't introduce any kind of noise to your noise floor. It is a fully transparent connection. Okay? Confided you're connecting it properly and you're not standing next to a transformer. Okay? That said, how would I use and where did I feel the Loki is sufficient and can add quality to your listening experience, and where does it fall short? Because it's only a 4-band EQ, it is limited in the range of frequencies that it can equalize, that it can tweak, but it also creates a wider correction, a wider Q factor, I think it's called, right? Factor? Correct me if I'm wrong. If I am below, let me know, okay? So that means it's covering a wider range of frequencies as well. And that, in my particular use case, was a bit of a deal breaker for me. And the reason being is, for instance, when I reviewed the Anandas or the Arias, actually I have a comparison video right over here. Yes, I'm plugging the crap out of my other videos. One of the things that I absolutely love about the Heifemann headphones, and one of the reasons I loved the THX parametric EQ, even compared to things like the RME-ADI-2, is the fact that it has this physicality, this percussive physical quality to the sub bass when you can dial it in just right. And when using the Loki Mini Plus, because you can get that low end rumble out of a nice planar magnetic headphone like the Ananda, for instance, but in doing so, because it's got a slightly wider correction, it also introduces a little bit of an enhancement in the mid bass as well, which adds a little bit of bloat to the sound. You lose a little bit of that feeling of sub-bass low-end clarity and precision by enhancing a little bit too much at the same time. That's the first reason why I found that adding those two extra frequencies to the Lokius makes that difference. It strikes that sweet spot for EQing where I can just increase the sub-bass just enough to bring up that physicality and only tweak the mid-bass enough to give it presence and give it fullness without bloating the sound. Something you can't do on the Loki Mini Plus. When it came to the mids are More of a generalized frequency to me, whether you're doing male or female vocals, whatever, or certain instruments. I didn't think that was too much of an issue. It helped to enhance or decrease the bloatiness of certain sounds. But again, when you get into the higher frequencies, depending on your age and depending on your sensitivity, or if you're somebody who's very high-end sensitive, then I feel that the low-key might introduce a little bit of clarity to the highs, but in the same time might add a little bit of sibilance to those who might be sensitive. Let's say you're under the age of 25 and you're more sensitive to, let's say, 18K. That might be a little bit of issue because it's kind of giving you a general boost in the highs. Again, something that I can add clarity in the higher frequency, but when it comes to the very high frequencies, getting into like the 16 or the 18, I can dial it back to reduce a little bit of sizzle and graininess, or a little bit of sibilance in the highest frequencies, while getting the voices to feel a little bit clearer. Like I said, it hits that sweet spot. Compared to the THX, the Monolith THX 788, I think that actually matters more depending on what kind of an amp you pair it with, because the 788 is a DAC amp combined. The Jotunheim is a powerhouse of an amp. It has a ridiculous, in my opinion, an overwhelming amount of power to it. And this can be a positive or a negative when paired up with an EQ, depending on the headphones that you're pairing it with. And that's where the Ananda versus the Focal come into the story. When listening to, for instance, the Focals on my THX amp, because the 788 isn't nearly as powerful as the Jotunheim, it's more of an average but sufficient powered headphone, how strongly it pushes the driver itself, the dynamic physical driver itself, will change depending on both the gain you're giving it and the frequency boost that you're giving it. And I found when EQing using a balanced connection, which gives you more gain, more power on the Jotunheim, versus the imbalanced connection or the less powerful THX amp, although it's more than sufficiently powerful, I found I got more power, more rumble, more dynamics out of the Focals. Whereas when I did this on the Jotunheim with too much gain and too much power, it actually created a mechanical distortion in the driver itself, because it's a dynamic driver. And it scared me. I increased the gain a little bit, and I took for granted the power of the gain on the Jotunheim on the Focals, because I usually use Heifemans most of the time. And it went, and I went, turned it down. I didn't want to blow up my driver. It was scary. So it forced me to kind of always be pushing it back in fears of pushing the driver too hard. So it was the inclusion of power plus gain in that frequency that caused sub-bass distortion in the driver itself. On the Ananda's, a planar magnetic is a sturdier, for lack of a better term, driver that can handle more power. It can handle more kick. So I much prefer to use a balanced connection with a Heifemann headphone, because it allows me to get that increase in dynamic range, increase in power that really make that driver move. That gives me that very satisfying physicality, that percussiveness in the sound. And because you have a nice range of a nice sound stage and nice frequency responses in Heifemann headphones generally, you can really tweak those sounds in and dial them in exactly the way you want them to. So I really felt, okay, if I'm really going to EQ, I'm going to use my Ananda's with it. But then I tried something out. I tried something I don't usually do, because I generally go balanced. I decided to plug in the single-ended headphone cable into it. And by introducing less power from the amp itself, it actually increased the dynamic range of the headphone. And all of a sudden, my headphones, my focals, rumbled without distorting. Because the thing is, by reducing the volume, by reducing the gain on the amp, you feel like you're kind of trying to dial it back in fears of damaging the driver. But when you give it less gain, it can handle the boost. So my recommendation, if you love Focal headphones, which are absolutely exquisite headphones, they're beautiful to listen to, but you don't want to over push because it's an incredibly low impedance headphone. It's overly sensitive to too much power like a Jotunheim. Single-ended output it, and you're going to get a much better, use a single-ended headphone cable, and you're going to be able to get a little bit more dynamic range out of it. And you're going to get the full satisfaction of EQ without the fears of pushing it. That said, if you really want to get everything out of your shit stack over here, I would personally lean you a little bit more towards getting a planar magnetic. And that also introduces us to another reason why you might want to get an EQ. And that is, it unlocks different headphones for you. A good example is the LCDX. I personally have always been in love with the LCDXC closebacks, and I reviewed them right over here. Okay, I found it had a more accurate frequency response, but the LCDX had that beautiful punch. It had a beautiful soundstage, but that freaking that mid to high sub bass bloat would just ruin the sound for me and made it sound like a cardboard box. It's really cheapened the sound. With an EQ, you can correct that. And audio reviewers like Andrew, for instance, or Josh Valor, love the LCDX. Andrew said, if you're not somebody who's afraid of EQing, you can get an exquisite sounding headphone and really get the advantage, take advantage of the advantages that the LCDX has to offer without suffering that shitty frequency response bloat in the high lows, okay? Another reason why you might want to EQ. Everybody's got their slight little preferences to them. And even though the Focals and the Anandas and the Arias and the Sundaras and all of these headphones have a beautiful frequency response, it's personal. You want your music to feel just right. And in that case, I find that that's where an EQ really comes in, because once your ears adapt to that kind of sound that you really, really love, when you can really tweak it to your personal preference and really adapt each headphone to kind of suit your fancy exactly the way you want to, when you hit that switch and turn it off, the bypass switch, it literally sounds like you took off a pair of high-end headphones that sounded gorgeous and you put on two Kleenex boxes over your ear. The music sounds utterly neutered without the EQ. Now, an audio purist is going to say, well, yes, because you've desensitized your hearing to a pure sound. The same way a nutritionist will say, stop eating junk food and you'll be able to enjoy a salad one day. You won't have to eat junk food to keep your mind and keep your senses overly stimulated. But I don't listen to music for health reasons. I listen to music because I get off on it. Because it's an excitement, because it's a visceral experience, because it transports me into this other world. It's an artistic experience. It's not a nutritional obligation. So no, I don't put a lot of sugar and cream in my coffee. I drink my coffee black, but when I listen to music, I like a little bit of sweet and creamy in my sound. So hopefully this will help you with your purchasing decision. Can I endorse this product? Do I say it's worthwhile? Do I think it's a really good quality product? I think it's fantastic. And I cannot wait for Shit to release their bigger grandpa version of this, which might even be a, I don't know, maybe a 16 band, 20 band EQ. I'm really not sure what it's going to be, but they're coming out with an even bigger version of this, a more versatile version EQ coming up really soon. So I'll be keeping my ears peeled for that update as well. So thank you very much for watching, everybody, and happy shopping. Take care.